live from the digital studios in Nome, Alaska, KNOM AM and FM in Nome. And my name is Rick Schmidt, and inviting all of you listening and everyone here at the studios for this dedication. I want to thank the mayor, Richard Bonneville, for showing up, and lots of other friends. Florence Busch is in from Anchorage, and invite you to come by for Mass in about 15 minutes. Somebody else who could not make it here is Paul Fortune, former news director at KNOM and the board president, and he sends along his greetings in this announcement.
Greetings to you, our honored guests at KNOM, and to you, our loyal listeners throughout Western Alaska. It's my privilege to share a few words from a distance as the president of the KNOM Radio Mission Board of Directors. And even though our AM and FM signals do not reach quite so far south as Sioux City, Iowa, I do feel closely connected with you on this remarkable day as we look forward toward the radio station's bright future and gaze back over the best of its past. Tom and Florence Busch are featured each and every hour on KNOM. Sometimes this occurs rather obviously in the way of archived classic audio, whether it be Eskimo stories and legends, historic Iditarod moments, or even animals in the news. But more often, if we're really listening carefully, we discern the voices of Tom and Florence via their vision and their values that still inspire the daily efforts and energies which KNOM devotes on behalf of the residents of Western Alaska, the real people of the great land. Times change, technology evolves, and volunteers and staffers come and go, as they have for nearly half a century. But what remains, and what resonates, as clearly in 2016 as in 1971, is Tom's and Flo's selfless and sustaining leadership, both by their lives and in their legacies. It is truly our privilege that their names will honor KNOM's new digital studios as we soon embark upon the second half century of our radio journey from the shores of the Bering Sea in the land of the midnight sun.
It is my pleasure now to introduce Father Ross Tozzi, who is a longtime board member of KNOM Radio Mission, Inc. Father Ross.
On July 14th, 1971, Pope Paul VI offered words of encouragement as KNOM began its very first broadcast. With the help of the Rotary Club International, Paul VI voiced a short message to inspire KNOM and its listeners. A few years earlier, in 1967, Pope Paul VI addressed a wider audience when he initiated a World Communications Day with a message on the power and the responsibility of mass media. Pope Paul VI explained, "One must give full credit at its true worth to the contribution made by the press, radio, and television, as well as the other instruments of social communication, to the enrichment of culture, to the spread of various artistic forms, to recreation, to mutual knowledge and understanding among peoples, and also towards the spread of the gospel message." These words of Paul VI have echoed in the mission of KNOM for over 45 years as it seeks to inspire, inform, educate, and entertain the people of Western Alaska and beyond. As KNOM embarks on a new chapter of its own history with the dedication of the Tom and Florence Busch Digital Studios, I turn to the words of Pope Francis and a few of the points he makes in the message for this year's 50th World Communication Day. "It is not technology which determines whether or not communication is authentic, but rather the human heart and our capacity to use wisely the means at our disposal. What we say and how we say it, our every word and gesture ought to express God's compassion, tenderness, and forgiveness for all. love, by its nature, is communication. It leads to openness and sharing. If our hearts and actions are inspired by charity, by divine love, then our communication will be touched by God's own power. As sons and daughters of God, we are called to communicate with everyone without exception. He goes on to say, let us try and recall our first experience of relationships within our families. Our parents loved us and valued us for who we are more than for our abilities and achievements. Parents naturally want the best for their children, but that love is never dependent on their meeting certain conditions. The family home is one place where we are always welcome. I would like to encourage everyone to see society not as a forum where strangers compete and try to come out on top, but above all, as a home or a family where the door is always open and where everyone feels welcome. For this to happen, we must first listen. Communication means sharing, and sharing demands listening and acceptance. Listening is much more than simply hearing. Hearing is about receiving information, while listening is about communication and calls for closeness. Listening allows us to get things right and not simply to be passive onlookers, users, or consumers. Listening also means being able to share questions and doubts, to journey side by side, to banish all claims to absolute power, and to put our abilities and gifts at the service of the common good. On this joyous occasion of the inauguration of KNOM's digital studios, I bring good tidings of our Bishop Chad Zielinski from Fairbanks. We congratulate and honor the many people who have served over the course of KNOM's 45 plus years. It is truly an award-winning radio station. And we humbly ask our Lord to continue to send workers into the vineyard, dedicated men and women like Tom and Florence Busch, who will continue that mission of utilizing technology with a human heart, of expressing God's compassion with tenderness, of communicating with listeners one-on-one to help build and empower a sense of family, to open doors and be welcome to strangers, and to empower people to place their abilities and gifts at the service of the common good. May KNOM continue to inspire, inform, educate, and entertain the people of Western Alaska beyond with mercy, love, and compassion. As part of our dedication, I will do a blessing of the new studios. That blessing comes from our Book of Blessings. So let us pray. Lord God Almighty, we humbly praise you, for you enlighten and inspire those who, by probing the powers implanted in creation, develop the work of your hands in wonderful ways. Look with favor on your servants, who use the technology discovered by long research. Enable them to communicate truth, to foster love, to uphold justice and right, and to provide enjoyment. Let them promote and support that peace between peoples which Christ the Lord brought from heaven, for he lives and reigns with you forever and ever.
Amen.
With water blessed for the church at St. Joseph, I now make my way, blessing people and our studios. The new studios are quite beautiful, and we thank Tom were the gift of his life to serve the people of Western Alaska. May God, the creator of all things, who never ceases to work his wonders among us, enlighten our minds so that we may know him more deeply and strive always to spread his truth and his peace. May Almighty God bless all of KNOM's listeners and all who enter through these doors to provide service. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. Amen.